Look at the fig tree and all the trees. When they are already budding, you see and know for yourselves that summer is now near. So you also, when you see these things happening, know that the kingdom of God is near. Luke 21:29-31. What will be the signs of Jesus' return and the end of the age here on earth? The Bible has given us very specific details of what that will look like on the earth, and we can see them happening right now. Let's look at some of the verses in the Bible that say what the world will look like in the end of the age and the return of Jesus Christ soon approaching, and see how much of a resemblance there is to the times that we're living in right now. Matthew 24:6-7. And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there will be famines, pestilence, and earthquakes in various places. So these are the signs that we will see before the end to come. Reuters, June 30th, 2021. Putin says Russia could have sunk UK warship without starting World War III. We see tensions between Russia and the UK with ships entering waters that both are claiming they have the right to enter. We see that, of course, if Russia were to shoot down a ship or something like that, that would easily provoke potentially World War III. We have Russia, China, and America, all world superpowers, right on the brink of constantly always causing issues with the other nations, fulfilling Matthew 24 of wars and rumors of wars. July 23rd, 2021 on the ussun.com. War of words, World War III fears as China boasts US would have no chance stopping invasion of Taiwan. We know China wants to invade Taiwan. There's these issues of Taiwan not wanting to be part or controlled by China. We have China in the South China Sea constantly provoking nations that enter them. They claim they have the rights to those waters. We're seeing these nations rise and build these tensions and these wars and rumors of wars constantly. Also in Matthew 24, we have it mentioning the famines, pestilence, and earthquakes in various places. According to Oxfam.org, today the world stands on the brink of unprecedented famines. About 30 million people are experiencing alarming hunger, severe levels of food insecurity, and malnutrition in northeastern Nigeria, South Sudan, Somalia, and Yemen. 10 million of them are facing emergency and famine conditions. Not only that, but we're seeing shorter growing seasons due to the grand solar minimum that's only going to continue. We're seeing the breakdown of these processing facilities, of trucking facilities due to the pandemic, that are causing breakdowns in society and how all these different commodities get transferred to each other. So that number is going to continue to grow and get worse, not only in third world nations, but in first world nations too. We're already seeing that now, and we're seeing inflation on food prices constantly day by day. That's most likely going to be getting worse. And eventually, because of prophecy, will 100% worse, probably going to continue from this point on. Matthew 24:23-24. Then if anyone says to you, look, here is the Christ, or there, do not believe it. For false Christs and false prophets will rise and show great signs and wonders to deceive, if possible, even the elect. Many different things that could be brought up within that. We can have false prophets and false Christ just claiming that they believe in Jesus Christ, but we also can have what I believe is a very real possibility that there would be quote-unquote alien contact, which would really be fallen angels or their offspring, something within the realm of fallen entities making contact with Earth, and that these people will say, oh, look, it's the Christ, or there's Jesus, there's Muhammad, all these things, and people will buy into it but do not believe it, even if they show great signs and wonders. MSNBC article says an Israeli general said aliens are real but avoiding humanity. That checks out. If aliens are out there, I would absolutely recommend that they avoid Earth and all its issues for now. So there's all this talk. We're seeing military video declassified of unidentified flying objects or aerial phenomenon in the skies. They're clearly setting the stage for alien contact, alien disclosure, and people will believe that those are gods when they're not. They're fallen entities. They're demonic in nature. 2 Peter 3:3-4. Knowing this first, that scoffers will come in the last days, walking according to their own lusts, and saying, where's the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of creation. We'll have scoffers, and we have them now, saying, Where's Jesus? Why isn't he returning? And especially as things get worse, and some lukewarm believers will believe these lies and say, it's gotten really bad. Jesus hasn't come back. I guess that was all a lie. That's what people who are lukewarm will believe. And we already see that now. Here's a book on Amazon, Indisputable Evidence That Jesus Is Not Coming Back. And we see all throughout society and mainstream culture that people mock Jesus Christ and say he's not real. And of course, he's not coming back. That's what they believe. But they will be sadly mistaken when he does come back and they have no more chance and no more time to repent of their sins and be accepted for eternal life. 2 Timothy 3:1-5, perilous times and perilous men. But know this, that in the last days perilous times will come. For men will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, unloving, unforgiving, slanderers without self-control, brutal, despisers of good, traitors, headstrong, haughty, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power, and from such people turn away. That's such a clear verse for the times that we're living in. We see so many people within culture and just within the world right now, as things have gotten worse and continue to, that men are lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boasters, proud, all of those things. We see that within almost every area of culture. It's one of the clearest signs of fulfilled prophecy going on right now today, because all those things are completely filled to the T, really. And not to forget, having a form of godliness but denying its power, I believe that to be the case for many Christians who do not believe in God and that he still has the power to do signs and wonders and miracles, because he does do those things. I've witnessed them myself. So don't forget that God has not changed. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hebrews 13:8. God still has power to do these miracles and to do amazing things. He does them all the time. There's testimonies all over the internet of the miracles and things that God has done. So don't deny the power of God and the power that is in his name. I mean, many people believe that there's demonic possession and there's evil and there's they do these satanic rituals and powers and get powers, but then they deny the fact that God does miracles and does powers like that. God still does, and he's way more powerful than them. So don't discount the fact that God is extremely powerful. He still is and always will be. And as the end of the age comes, we will see more miraculous signs from God as well. And we will see power and miraculous things. There will be a huge revival in the end times, but there will also be huge persecution of Christians. So these are the signs and the times that we will see probably very soon. I'm 100% within the next 30 years, I would say, at the very, very most. But it could really all start tomorrow. We are seeing the stage set as we see all these prophecies are being fulfilled. Luke 21:25-26, the coming of the Son of Man. And there will be signs in the sun, in the moon, and in the stars, and on the earth distress of nations, with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring, men's hearts failing them from fear and the expectation of those things which are coming on the earth, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. These signs here, I don't believe we have fully seen come to its fulfillment yet, but we are seeing different things like that. We see signs in the sun, moon, and stars. Many of them are not abnormal, but we are seeing them kind of on an uptick compared to what we're really used to. Men's hearts failing them from fear and the expectation of those things which are coming on the earth. I believe that could very well be also tied to the alien deception, when these fallen entities somehow manage to break through the dimension they're locked in and are brought forth onto the earth. Men's hearts will fail them when those things happen, and the powers of the heavens will be shaken. That could also be tied to that too, because we see these unidentified flying aerial phenomenon within the heavens and within the skies, and they will be shaken. But we'll see signs in the sun, moon, and stars. We know the moon at one point will turn to blood, and all the stars will be darkened in the last days. So these are signs to watch for. Some of the signs that we are seeing currently in the heavens are, one of the interesting ones is the solar eclipse that will be in 2024. And they're calling it, on this website, the novelty of the cross, because we will see in America, compared to the solar eclipse in 2017, and like I mentioned, the one in 2024, when it comes through America, it will be a cross right over America. And we can see here in this picture that that's what it will be, like an X or from the side, like a cross, right around Illinois, Missouri, and Tennessee is right where that point will be. Matthew 24:14, and this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world as a witness to all the nations, and then the end will come. According to the website Missionary Portal, it says how many missionaries are in the world, and this is in 2017, an estimated 430,000 full-time missionaries serving in another country. There were 1,135,000 home missionaries and 400,000 short-term missionaries in 2001, with 5.5 million full-time Christian workers, a mere 7.6% are serving in another country. We see that, and then we also see online how many people are spreading the gospel and how that's getting out to the whole world. The gospel is getting out to the entire world. Clear fulfilled prophecy of what was told would come is happening right now. And people need the message of the gospel to save their soul before the end comes. So people need to hear it. God's going to give them a chance. And we're seeing that people are out in the world spreading the gospel, and they're doing it more than ever. And those dates are years old. So we know that that's going on more now. More fulfulfillment of prophecy we're seeing. And it's incredible to see these things, how long ago they were written. And then they're happening right now. There's no other book, there's no other religion in the world where that's the case. Such clear proof of the Bible and prophecy. But just like Jesus said, some people, even if they saw the dead raised, even then they would not believe. Matthew 24:42-44. Watch therefore, for you do not know what hour your Lord is coming. But know this, that if the master of the house had known what hour the thief would come, he would have watched and not allowed his house to be broken into. Therefore, you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. Always be ready for Jesus Christ. Get your life right with Jesus Christ today, because you don't know what hour he's coming back and what time these things are all going to take place. Not only that, but you don't know what your life holds and how long, honestly, you will be alive on the earth. The most important thing is to be right with the Lord Jesus Christ and get rid of sin if you're living in it. Luke 21:28, now when these things begin to happen, look up and lift up your heads, because your redemption draws near. So it's not a time to be fearful. It's not a time to worry. God has a plan. God is with us. So lift up your heads and keep your heads up, and don't be worried or scared or fearful for the times that we're living in, because our redemption draws near. And the next age that we will be living in will have none of this stuff going on. And none of this evil will be going on at all. So we have hope to look for. We have an eternity of peace. And Jesus will be coming back to bring redemption and righteousness and a millennial reign of peace on the earth when all evil is wiped away forever. Many fulfillments of prophecies happening now. We're seeing it in the daily news. Incredible proof of the Bible through prophecy that we see fulfilled constantly. Keep your head up, because our redemption draws near. Thanks for watching, and God bless.